My name is Chloe, and I'm 22 years old from Phoenix, Arizona, and this is my sister, Anna. As you can probably already tell, we're conjoined twins. Now, you may be wondering how in the world. Well, it all began when my mother was rushed to the hospital in anticipation of her first child being born. Little did she know it wasn't going to be just one child. Well, kind of. Our birth came as a complete surprise to both our parents, the doctors, and the rest of the world. After we were born, the doctors attempted to steal us for medical experiments. But luckily, our father knew his rights and got us out of there before anyone else could get to us. Anna and I have been on the move ever since. Due to all of the news coverage and never-ending doctors trying to capture us, our parents decided to move us to a small town in Nevada. So everything we do has to get split into two. For example, when working out, I must control the right leg while she controls the left. Or when we're typing on the computer, I have to control the right hand while she controls the left. Sometimes things do go faster though, for example, laundry or doing homework. But that doesn't mean we agree on everything. We're literally complete opposites. I like to exercise and go on a lot of adventures while she likes to stay indoors and watch TV. She loves to eat meat while I am vegan. I guess you can say we balance each other out. Another big problem we encountered a lot was when it came to boys. Anna likes guys with dark features, but I tend to gravitate toward blondies. But I'll have to stay. We both really wanted to become an animal shelter owner. So we agreed on working at our local animal shelter. Even though we looked much different than anyone else, the small town of Ely, Nevada respected and looked up to us. But this all came to a halt when Anna started getting sick. In the past, we'd both get sick at the same time if it was a cold or fever. But we did get warned early on in our life by the crazy doctors that one of us received stronger genes than the other. The effect started with Anna passing out at random times. This became an issue because while we were in class or working at the animal shelter, she'd pass out and half of our body was immobile for hours. On top of that, we've grown together so much that I couldn't do anything without her being by my side, literally. The third time was worse. She passed out and wouldn't wake up. After waiting 3 hours, we decided to visit the only doctor we trusted to see what was going on with Anna and our body. The doctor said that because I was born with stronger genes, my body was fighting hers, and all her organs were shutting down. He also said that if we don't remove the dying organs in time, there could be a risk of my organs failing as well. Anna and I knew this might happen in the future and talked it through. She told me that if it had come to this, she wanted me to continue our dream of opening an animal shelter and having people come from all over the world to help their pets recover. When we meet again, I'll tell you all about the animals I saved and the beautiful animal shelter we built. For now, wish us luck on this surgery, and see you on the other side. Just wanted to tell my tale. Thanks for listening.